never be more loved than I am right now. Wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Ooh.
Going through a storm, but I won't go down. I hear your voice carried in the rhythm of the wind to call me out. You would cross an ocean, so I wouldn't drown. You've never been closer than you are right now.
Let's sing about it, y'all.
You are Jireh.
I can see so clear what it's all about.
So stay by my side when the sun goes down. Don't wanna forget how I feel right now.
Jireh,
Jireh, you are enough.
I know that you are.
Jireh,
you are
enough.
I'm
in every circle.
more than you ask,
think or imagine.
So let your
Yes, it is, yeah. Who you are, we make it.
Hey. Let's sing this together. Even when I don't see it. Come on, even when.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working.
Come on!
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop.
Good morning. I invite you to kindly stand as we begin this service. Jesus said, I am the life, the resurrection, and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I'm sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord, both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. This morning we are gathered in this sacred place for a service of thanksgiving for the life of Hallam Roger Gittins Yard. Let us pray as we receive his body for burial. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother, Hallam Roger, for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he would raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray, O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother Hallam. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gates of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We join our voices together as we sing the hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints,
the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. Kindly be seated. We will now receive a poet tribute, which would be followed by the Bible reading.
Morning, church. My deep sympathy to the whole family, especially my friend Kev. And I just want to say that Roger was an example to follow. It was as simple as that. He was so versatile. And as a fellow artist, I give him full praise because he was self-taught. Everybody knows about his work with BT and all of that, Cable and Wireless. But I wrote this poem in tribute to him. Hallam Roger Giddings was no ordinary man. He was an innovator, a man of skill, a man of will, a bona fide creator. He worked at Cable and Wireless until it changed to BET. He loved sports with a passion, played football and hockey. With skill and determination, a fitness fellow was he. But it was in lawn tennis we saw his dancing feet. His thinking mind, he was one of a kind and very hard to defeat. He loved all music genres. I speak now only facts. But Bach, Beethoven, and Tchaikovsky made Hallam relax. His recreational moments were full of laughter and cheer. Slamming dominoes, defeating his foes, sipping rum and coke, and enjoying a Banks beer. He retired as network manager there at BET. Some of Hallam's fellow workers shedded tears openly. Conscious of the environment, he was always pleased if he saw anybody planting scrubs or trees. He was a master craftsman, self-taught, this ain't no joke, whose outstanding works hang proudly in Parliament and Ellara Court. And so now we bid farewell to a giant, a man among men. May his soul, his wonderful soul, rest in peace until we meet again.
Thank you.
And this morning, I said, do I have to bring my guitar? And they said, of course, Gabby. So this is my tribute to Hallam.
Life is a stage we live on, fully engaged since we born, playing a role that we've been given by the Creator who watches on. Sometimes it seems life is hard. You will receive only bad. Don't be afraid. Don't give up the struggle. Keep your head high. You will get by. And you will be playing your role well. You will be avoiding hell. Mm-hmm. And at the end of your days, at your setting sun, the Creator will say to you, well done, well done, well done, well done, well done. I too will come. Be prepared. Sadness and bliss will be shared. Then suddenly things will get better. Don't be complacent. See the future. Save all you can. Fill your need. But don't ever sow seeds of greed. Love your neighbor as you love your person. Life will be complete. Life will be sweet. And you will be playing your role well. You will be avoiding hell. At the end of your days, at your setting sun, the Creator will say to you, well done. Well done, well done, well done, well done. Ooh. 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 Mm-hmm. Act three will be Father Time creeping on you down the line. Don't be ashamed when you no longer can rendezvous like youngsters do. Show them the ways, all the walls. Help them avoid life's pitfalls. Helping them through is really helping your own offspring. Do the same thing, and you will be playing your role well. You will be avoiding hell. And at the end of your days, at your setting sun, the Creator will say to you, well done, well done, well done. Hallam, you was an artist. Hallam, no one could deny this. But Hallam, you was always so fair. Whenever you did your work as an engineer, you was a father, a teacher, a brother forever. All of we would miss you true and true. Well done, Hallam, well done, well done. Hallam, well done, well done.
Bible reading is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, reading from verse 1 to verse 8. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to throw away, a time to tear, and a time to sow, a time to keep silence, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace. This is the word of the Lord.
We will now receive a musical tribute, White a Shade of Pale, and this will be followed by the eulogy and tributes for today.
Just go sleep. Good morning, everyone. Firstly, I want on behalf of the entire family to thank all of you for supporting us through this most difficult time. It really means a lot to us, and it's greatly appreciated. I'm first going to read a tribute on behalf of Ajani. I had the best grandfather I could ever ask for. He was very kind, yet also stern when needed. He cared for me a lot, and he had a great sense of humor. Granddad loved to laugh and would always tell jokes. There was never a dull moment around him. He also enjoyed playing games with me. Granddad was always there when you needed. He would give great advice. He loved to counsel and offer many stories about life, from which I learned many lessons. He would always go out of his way to make sure that we were well taken care of. He watched me grow from the time I was born and helped to raise me and be the person that I am today. He was more than a granddad. He was a mentor and a father figure. Some of you may know him as Hallam or Roger or Yardi, but for me, he was granddad. Granddad would drop anything to do something for my sister and I. He did not need any notice or any forewarning. If we needed to go anywhere or needed to be picked up, you could count on him to be the first one to get us there and help us, whether it was dropping us to school or picking us up from school, taking us to our many after-school activities or sports, or if we just wanted to go somewhere. Granddad and I would often play games when I was younger. For example, anytime we were in the car driving to or from somewhere, he would read a license plate, and we'd have to add the first two and the last two numbers and see who could answer first with the correct answer. These were my first math classes. Some of my favorite memories of him or with him are our after school and after sports activities. When he would pick me and my sister up from school and we came home, he would always turn on the TV to channel 704. This was the game show channel. Whenever he had the channel set, it would not change until it was time for the 7 o'clock news. However, I did not mind this at all, as I would always sit with him on evenings and we'd watch all the game shows together and play as long as they were going on, sharing and comparing our answers out loud. We had our own game show. He would also comment on how we even shared almost the same birthday. He would say how close they were together, that his was 4 days apart from mine, my uncle's was 3 days apart from my sister's, and so on. He had a thing for numbers. Granddad has taught me many life lessons, lessons which I will never forget and hope to live by and be half the man that he was. I will always remember him as the best granddad there ever will be, and I know he will always be there watching over me as my life continues, and I will always have love for him as I know he has always loved me. On behalf of Ayodele, dear Granddad, I wish I could go back in time to tell you again and again how grateful I am to have been able to call you my granddad, the most reliable, supportive, and loving granddad to exist. From picking up and dropping off at school to all our various extracurricular activities, whenever I needed you, I could always depend on you to show up for me. I remember our afternoon trips to JB's, you teaching me geography, and us adding up license plate numbers to sharpen our math skills. No matter the time of day or occasion, whenever I called, you would be there for me and Ajani. I will never forget watching game shows with you on evenings, picking up mangoes in the backyard, or even going for walks on the hill after school. Just spending time with you, I would make your entire day. I will miss you deeply, and there will never be another soul that could replace one as kind, selfless, and loving as yours. You are an incredible man, husband, and grandfather. Today is an honor and celebration of the incredible person you are, and I hope you will be able to rest in peace, knowing that you are deeply loved forever. Hallam Roger Gittins Yard. Hallam Roger Gittins Yard, affectionately known as Roger Yard or Yardy, was born on January the 11th, 1939, to the late Mabel and Leo Yard. He was the last born of that union. He had two brothers, Carl and the late Archer Yard, and one sister, the late Grace Seeley. To this day, we do not know how Roger was able to convince Anita to return to Barbados from Canada after being there for 10 years to come back to marry him. However, he did, and they were married on September 25th, 1965. They have been married for the last 57 years, so I guess he knew, or Anita knew, what they were doing. This marriage produced three children, Paula, Robert, and Kevin. Roger started to work at Cable and Wireless at the tender age of 17. It was here that he found out that his first name was actually Hallam. Up to this point, he knew himself as Roger. He then used Hallam for official business only. He worked at Cable and Wireless and continued to work with BET when the company changed hands. At one point, BET was offering early retirement packages. Roger quickly volunteered himself for an early package. This was not, however, to be, as it was not accepted. He was then offered a management position, which he worked in until he eventually retired, and he worked there for 43 years. He retired at the age of 60, something that we wouldn't get to do these days. Roger was a simple man who had many passions, but he was also a visionary with his ideas. He had a healthy respect for the environment. He advocated that each household should have food or fruit planted on the property and boasted of having guavas, tangerines, oranges, shaddocks, mangoes planted all around the house in whatever little space. The guava trees were a steady source of guava jelly and guava cheese that was made routinely. The respect for the environment was not just in talk. He built his own gravity reuse water tank system long before there was any requirement for water storage in Barbados. He also designed and built his composting system. He believed in not wasting, and so we were not allowed to throw away any fruit or raw food scraps or peelings. They had to be placed in the compost bin. This compost bin was redesigned several times to ensure that the moisture content, the oxygen levels, and everything were perfect so that the end product would be perfect. Roger was an early adopter to technology, and these were frequently discussed in the house. Robust discussions were held on which ones we thought had potential and which we thought would fail. He made an early investment in a computer, the now infamous Commodore 64. He also had a mobile phone as soon as they became available on island, and we used to tell him that he had his own personal phone booth. But he always said that the dial-up house phone, as we know it, would eventually become obsolete, and I think we are virtually there. Roger knew his geography tall, as the young people would say, and could tell you which tropic, time zone, and location you would be in whenever you said you were traveling to some destination or you just wanted to know where a particular country that you heard about, where it was. Although he was a walking he knew his geography well, he still purchased the old-fashioned, what we call the old-fashioned Google. He had the entire adult and children's suite of encyclopedias. He also professed not to have a love for politics, but he would listen, or we would listen, to the parliamentary debates, which resulted in healthy discussions on the topics that were being debated. Apart from these skills, he was athletic and played hockey and football in his early years, but then, as you heard Gabby say, he played lawn tennis until he could play no more. Many days were spent by the children at the BT grounds, running around the pasture, trying to play tennis, or rather knocking the ball when allowed, or scoring the matches for the adults. This greatly influenced Kevin in his tennis interests, so much so that Kevin ended up playing and coaching tennis for Barbados. The tennis interest meant also that when international tennis was being played on TV, this was what everyone in the house watched. There was no changing of channels. And of course, when Serena and Venus came on the scene, every match they played was watched and done so with great enthusiasm. Lots of shouting and oohs and ahs and sideline coaching happened in the Yard household. Roger had a slight interest in woodwork and joinery, and after spending many hours at Daniel's joinery shop on Culloden Road, he found that he had a love and a passion for lathe work. He also found he had an affinity to mahogany. This was what he worked on most of the time. He surprised himself with the ease with which he came to him and how he could turn out many different designs. He lamented that this was his true calling. He had a keen eye and perfected his craft. His mantra was, whatever you do, do it to the best of your ability, even if it was raking leaves. He would therefore spend hours sanding and staining and spraying to ensure the perfect masterpiece. And as you heard, some of his pieces are displayed in Parliament buildings, Alara Court, many churches and households. As I previously said, Roger had many passions, and another one was music and dancing. He had a collection of classical music, and the song you heard just now was one of his favorites. And Beethoven echoed loudly throughout the entire house when music was being played, much to our dismay, however. Large, special speakers were built and installed upstairs and downstairs to ensure that the music could be heard throughout each corner of the house. There was no escaping the sounds. Today, as children, we have a greater appreciation for the classics. Dancing was treated with no less enthusiasm. Roger loved to dance even more than he loved music. He and Anita would start the party and end it, having completed several laps around the dance floor, regardless to if anyone else was dancing or not. Roger insisted that he was not a fan of Christmas. However, coincidentally, he was off almost every Christmas time into the new year and to his birthday. He would complain somewhat about the things that Anita wanted installed around the house, but secretly, we thought that he enjoyed it. He loved to see and would swim to the boats and beyond. When he retired, the sea baths would be a daily morning routine. Roger enjoyed his grandchildren and took them everywhere they needed to go. He confessed, and I quote, "If I knew having grandchildren would be so sweet, I would have had them first." End of quote. He was blessed with a great grandson who he adored. If you listened to me carefully, you would have realized that my father, Hallam Roger, lived a very full and abundant life. In his latter years, he had Alzheimer's. However, Daddy died peacefully in his sleep, as he would have wished. May he rest in eternal peace and rise in glory.
Follow My Way by Shad Brown.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is a musical tribute from my godmother, Eleanor Small. She is like a sister to Anita and Roger. He did it his way. And now the end is here, and so we face the final curtain. Friends, I say it clear, I state this case of which I'm certain. He lived a life this full, he traveled each and every highway. Oh, more, much more than this, he did it his way. Regrets, he had a few, but then again, too few to mention. He did what he had to do and saw it through without exemption. He planned his charted course, each careful step among the byway. And more, much more than this, he did it his way. Yes, there were times I'm sure you knew when he bit off more than he could chew. And through it all, when there were doubts, he had it up and spit it out. He faced it all and he stood tall and did it his way. He lived, he left and cried, he had his fill, his share of losing. And now, as we all cry, we find it all, huh, so amusing to think he did all that. And may I say, not in a shy way, oh no, oh no, not him, he did it his way. For who was Roger, what had he got, if not himself, then he has not, to say the thing he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows he gets some blows, I'm sure he did, and did it his way. Thank you.
Before I speak a few words of reflection, I wish to extend my condolences to Anne. Anita, life has a way of swinging around, because when I was living abroad just before coming back home these last 3 years, she was there for my dad. You can never get in anything with the modernites. And I wouldn't try, I'm too young for that. But she was there, and I wish to extend on behalf of my family and to publicly say thank you for being there for Daddy before he passed. And I think this is one of the humbling experiences to stand here for you today as you say goodbye to Roger with you and the family. I speak to you now in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus constantly gave us words of comfort. In his word, we are familiar with the word, "Don't be troubled, trust God and trust in me," John 14. I'm going to prepare a place for you, and when everything is ready, I will come and get you so that you will always be with me where I am. And very often, questions are asked, but how do we get there? How are we to be ready when he comes? The song that was just sung and the tribute that was done by my good friend, within it sends a message that says to us that we will be ready if we live our life according to his will, using our gifts and skills. Loving family. And being very conscious that we were created by one who was higher than us, and that one day he will come and take us to be with him. Because he's the only one who can take us to this place he's talking about. One of those many rooms in his and in our Father's heavenly home. How can we be ready? Well, now that's a challenge because we've got to do that in the midst of all of this, death and funerals, grief and loss, not to mention all the other things that were share with us in our Ecclesiastes reading. Being rooted up, tearing down, weeping and mourning and scattering and searching and giving up and throwing away, being torn, silence, hate and war. And yet, today as you come to say goodbye, you remember the deceased as one who made the best of things in his time. With a smile. And from what I was listening or what I heard, he seemed to be one who was very determined to do things, even before the song, his way. I also heard that despite the hardship and challenges he may have experienced in his life, as the soloist just said, the hard knocks and hard blows, he, like us, lived the things that happened in Ecclesiastes. For there was a time for him to be born, and that was no accident, for as for God's concern, he was created in God's image and sent to this earth for his purpose. And I'm sure that many of you who are here and would have experienced him and interacted with him can give God thanks for that. Then, of course, there's the much planting of a busy life, work life, and friendships, and healing and building and laughing and dancing. And it is interesting, I didn't know much about Roger, but I had on the line here, I can just imagine him as a young man in his life with some dancing involved. I am sure that he danced his wife's shoes off, wooing her. I'm sure in his lifetime there was embracing and gathering and keeping precious things, mending and speaking love and peace. There were lots of blessings and pleasures in his life, and I'm sure that if I was to give each one of you the opportunity, there would be something that you can share that meant a lot to you having met this man. But for Hallam, all of that is over. He's in the hands of God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who created and loved him. But we, however, are still experiencing our time for everything under the sun. For our seasons, for our own activities under heaven, and living all of this out. The question for each one of you present here at this service of Thanksgiving is, how are you doing that? How are you living your life out according to Ecclesiastes? Like our brother, are you making the most of the time that is given to you? We do our best not to let ourselves be troubled by the impact of the negativity of the world that we live in. We try to implement in our lives, just as Jesus said, that peace that he and he alone can offer. You see, because for one day, people will be gathering someplace to say goodbye to you or to me. And therefore, as we sit here, I urge you to consider what Jesus said very carefully and what the wise man reminded us of, that there is a time. What time are you in? Do you know what time you're in? We must remember, even as we come to say goodbye, that life is so fragile. And therefore, it is important for us to use our time wisely. Even as we experience all the long list of things happening under the sun. Jesus says in the gospel, "For I am the only way to one of those rooms in my Father's heavenly home." Jesus is saying also, "I am the one who is able to walk with you and help you to make the most of your time here on earth." Therefore, the fact of that song we heard, "I did it my way," is also Jesus' reminder to each one of us that we have life given only to us by him, and therefore we live and move and have our life in him, our being in this Christ who in this God who created us. I believe he would have reminded Hallam that in all that he may have done, that it is I who have given you such gifts and skills and life. And now, having taken him to himself, he has allowed us to have this gift of being reminded that we now have to think about our own life. In the midst of our tears, in the midst of the void that is inside, what are we now going to do with our time? I do not trivialize the grief that you bear, that the void or the void that you have, but I also ask you to remember that you too now must carry on in this your season and your time. So in the midst of all our seasons and activities, our birthing and dying, our weeping and laughing, our mourning and dancing, we hear that wooing voice of Jesus saying to us, where am I in your life? What part do I play in your life? Funerals, therefore, need not be only a time of grief, but also a time of quiet reflection. A time when we pause from all that we're doing to look at our own life and what we're doing in this our time and this our season. My sister and family, the God who created your loved one is right here with you. And even though you physically cannot touch him, he is never far away. Psalms 23 reminds us that he does not send us through these valleys or these times by ourselves, but that he is right there with us. Psalms 46 says, I am a present help. So he is right here with you, but in the midst of your grief, he also whispers quietly to you, trust me with your life so that I can help you get through this season, and not only this season, but the days ahead. For all these lovely people are here with you now, but then they will go on to carry on with their season, and it will just be you and even your children or your other grandchildren, they too must carry on. But in the midst of all of this, Jesus whispered quietly to each one of you, trust me to help you carry on in this your season. How shall we? Who will respond to that amazing invitation? Let not your heart be troubled. All those who realize the frailty of life and the importance of being in the presence of God. Today, as you say goodbye, as we give God thanks for the life of our brother in this his season, we also extend our hand to the one who walked with him and the one who wants to walk with you. As he says, let not your heart be troubled. Trust me. Trust me in this your time and season. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. I invite you now to stand as we have our closing prayer and commendation. Kindly stand. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory. Blessed be God, our Father, the creator and preserver of all life. Blessed be Jesus Christ, the Savior and Redeemer of mankind. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the enabler and sustainer of those who seek for grace. Grant us, Lord, the wisdom and grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth. Lead us to repent of our sins, the evil we have done and the good we have failed to do. And strengthen us to follow the steps of your Son in the way that leads to the fullness of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. Let us commend our brother, Hallam Roger, to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your mighty power, you have given us new life in Christ Jesus. We entrust Hallam Roger to your merciful keeping. In the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, O Lord, who died and rose again to save us and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. And the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Our recessional hymn, When the Roll is Called Up Yonder. Great and glorious morning. When the saved of God is gathered over on the earth, in the road, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, bright and glorious morn, the dead in Christ shall rise, glory of his resurrection sheep, when his chosen one shall gather to the I want to make one very special request of you. I want to invite all the men who are here, all these gentlemen who would have known Roger and Slam Dominoes and had a little beer, to sing in his honor today. the very last verse. Just the men, and we ladies will join you on the chorus. Please do not embarrass your friend. So let's just try now as you sing, "Let us labor for the master from the dawn till setting sun." Only the men. And as we prepare to go, ladies, we will not be left out. So we will gently and softly speak to on that bright and glorious morning, and we'll just make sure, ladies, that we wave at Roger when we see him. So we will sing as the director comes and the pallbearers prepare themselves. We sing on that bright and cloudless morning, "Ladies Only Now." Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. For Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death and giving life to those in the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you. Into paradise may the angels lead you. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem."
slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like this. Worship your holy name. Bless you, time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore. Forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Come on. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy. Worship Your holy name, Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. Worship Your holy name, Jesus, I will worship Your holy name. Worship Your holy
faithfulness. Great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. Lord, unto me.
place where mercy reigns and never dies. There's a place where streams of grace flow deep and wide, where all the love ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing down. At the cross, at the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in all of you, I'm in.
All powerful, unconquerable.
By our sin. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, Savior, deliver us from the bitter pain of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Hallam Roger, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother Hallam Roger and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your son, Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom all the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good example of all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have a perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. We pray for this family. Grant, O Lord, to all who have bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up his countenance upon him and give him peace. Unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. the hymn. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, you have taught me to say, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well with my soul.
Oh!
To God be the glory, great things he has done. And during the singing of the hymns, you would be directed as you come to lay your floral tribute. To God be the glory. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound.
Bye. was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear. The
In the sweet by and by.
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
We shall sing on that beautiful shore the melodious songs of the blessed, and our spirits shall sorrow no more, not a sigh for the blessings of rest.
In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
To our bountiful Father above, we will offer the tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessings that hallow our days.
In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
In the sweet
Let us pray. Father of all, by whose mercy and grace your saints remain in everlasting light and peace, we remember with thanksgiving those whom we love but see no longer. And we pray that in them your perfect will may be fulfilled. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. And the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit rest and remain with you always. Amen.
Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you. Be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you.